Hi students, in this session we are going to discuss about difference between VAT and GST. First of all, what is GST and what is VAT? VAT is a value added tax. So tax will be collected from only state governments or state or union territory governments, and GST applicable enter the nation. GST applicable enter the nation. So GST collected both state and central governments equal share. First of all, GST jurisdiction. VAT was imposed only upon the goods sold within a particular state, only for particular state. Interstate transaction will not covered under VAT system, under VAT. Okay, so it means, so VAT, in case of the VAT applicable at the time in any interstate transaction during VAT period, we are pay tax CST 2%. CST full form, Central Sales Tax. The rate of tax 2% on sales at the time of CST applicable. Okay, students. And VAT was imposed only upon goods are sold within the state transaction only. And GST is applicable on transaction within a state, intrastate. Intrastate means within a state, as well as transaction across the state borders. It means interstate transaction. So GST applicable for both interstate and intrastate transactions. What VAT is applicable for only intrastate transaction. There is not covered under interstate transactions. That is the jurisdiction differences. Okay, and scope. VAT is applicable only on goods. So at the time of VAT applicable, if any person can service rendered or service given to any other person, the tax will be paid 14.5% is the service tax. It is a separate tax. So VAT only applicable for goods, but services applicable only for service tax. So these are the both are different in at the time of VAT system, at the time of VAT system. But GST is applicable on both goods as well as services also. Both goods and services applicable in GST term. Okay, then taxable event. It means in VAT, taxable event is sale of goods. So tax will be collected on the sales of goods in VAT system. But in GST system, taxable event is supply of goods. Both are the difference, supply of goods and sale of the good. Sale of the good means one person to another person. Supply of the goods, so it will be supply from retailer to consumer. Next, cascading effect. It partially eliminates cascading effect. First of all, what is cascading effect? Cascading effect means SSE or a person can pay two or more taxes on a single product. So that is called treated as a cascading effect. So in the GST system, cascading effect is zero, or cascading effect eliminate in GST regime, and VAT system partially or small eliminates cascading effect as क्रेडिट इज नॉट अवेलेबल फॉर सेंट्रल सेल्स टैक्स और एक्साइज ड्यूटी. ओके सो इट इज ए पार्शियली एलिमिनेटेड बट जीएसटी एलिमिनेट्स कास्केडिंग इफेक्ट एज सीमलेस क्रेडिट इज अवेलेबल. ओके इट इज कॉल्ड कास्केडिंग इफेक्ट एंड टैक्स क्रेडिट only intrastate transactions get input credit set off, not interstate transactions. So my dear student, it is the most important part, so listen carefully. So at the time of purchase the wholesaler or retailer already paid some tax on the product. After he sell the goods to the consumer, at that time when collected from the consumer, he will deduct the tax already paid to the manufacturer. So the tax amount will be deducted. That is called input tax credit. So only intrastate transactions get input tax set off. Only intrastate transactions mean within the state transaction only applicable input tax credit, it means ITC. okay, but not applicable for interstate transaction. Why? Because interstate transactions cannot be paid VAT. Why? Because more than the one state we are going to exchange or sell or buy the goods, the tax CST is applicable. CST full form, sales service central sales tax is applicable. The tax rate CST is only 2%. That's why not given the input tax credit at the time of VAT system. But in GST, input tax credit set off to be available for intrastate as well as interstate transaction. But in GST regime or GST system, the interstate and intrastate both states also applicable input tax credit. Okay, so you will set off the input tax credit. Next one, tax collection. Only state government gets the whole share of tax. So at the time of VAT, the total percentage of tax will be collected from the state government. So the state government cannot be given the any single paisa to the central government. But in GST, collected under SGST and CGST. SGST for state goods and service tax, the SGST amount going to the state government, and CGST central goods and service tax amount going to the collected from the consumers. So it the amount going to the central government and amount shared by center and state. Okay students, next, input credit. VAT liability is calculated by deducting input VAT on goods purchased and from output VAT on goods sold. So VAT system, at the time of VAT system, VAT total calculated and deduct the VAT, input VAT from on goods purchased and from output VAT on goods sold. So formula of VAT minus output tax minus input tax is equal to tax payable amount at the time of VAT system. And GST is applicable on goods as well as services provided. Next, return filling. VAT return must be filed 20th of succeeding month means immediate next month. For example, April tax will paid May 20th, before the May 20th, that is the succeeding month, immediate next month. Okay, next, GST return must be filed for sale by 10th of purchasing सेल बाय 10th, परचेसिंग बाय 15th एंड पेमेंट बाय 20th ऑफ सक्सीडिंग मंथ नेक्स्ट मंथ. ओके सो सेल्स अमाउंट सेपरेटली गिवन. नेक्स्ट 10th, purchasing amounts separately given to the government by 15th of succeeding month, and finally payment, tax payment paid by business dealer before 20th of succeeding month. This is the return filling. Registration is already we discussed. Registration depending upon the tax identification number, TIN number based registration VAT system, at the time of VAT system TIN based registration available applicable, and at the time of GST system PAN based registration, PAN based permanent account number based registration applicable. Permanent account number, write down number. Okay, next, threshold limit means maximum and minimum limits. So if cross the threshold limit, so compulsory you are the registered certain tax system. If you are below the limit, so it is a optional for your registration. So if you need the registration, then you will take a registration. If you don't require, so you will not take any registration below the threshold limit. So in VAT system, threshold limit is state specific, mostly 10 lakhs. So below 10 lakhs turnover, 10 lakhs means turnover. What is turnover? Turnover means annual sales means not from January to December. So all accounts are treated as from April 1st onwards to 31st March. That is the accounting year. So we will treat it as a accounting year only. So in a accounting year, one accounting year, you will cross the your sales amount more than the 10 lakhs, you will compulsory registered and VAT system. Okay, next GST registration common limit 20 lakhs at the time of 2017, 20 lakhs, nowadays 40 lakhs. Okay, 40 lakhs is the minimum limit. So if you cross the threshold limit of 20 lakhs, so you will compulsory registered under GST with PAN number, and you will not cross the or not more than you will not cross the 20 lakhs of limit. It is a your optional registration. If you want, take it registration. If you not required, do not take any registration from the government. It is your optional. So it's a business dealer optional point. Next, online payment is not compulsory at the time of VAT system. Online payment is not compulsory. So why? Because so VAT system, at the time of VAT system, the business dealers will pay the treasury bills. Keep in your mind, this is a important point. Treasury bill in State Bank of India, they will go to the SBI and filling the a treasury bill form and paid the tax directly, tax through cash. That is the VAT system. But GST system, online payment is compulsory. If tax is more than 10,000 rupees, why? Because eliminating the third party transactions or eliminating the formalities, eliminating the bank charges, so eliminating the frauds. So GST is the compulsory online payment if tax is more than 10,000. In case below 10,000, if you interested, you will pay online or offline, whatever it is, depending upon the business dealer requirement. Okay, Next, declaration form. Declaration form. At the time of VAT system, declaration form C, H, etc. are applicable. So compulsory declaration form given some one person to another, one business holder to another business holder, like C form, like H form, are compulsory required. But in GST, at the time of GST, no such declaration forms required. No such declaration forms required from any person to another person. Why? Because it is already online. So only GST registration number will take in the supply of person. Who is supply the goods? So he will take your GST registration number and mention his returns your GST number. So directly input tax credit given to your GST account. Okay, that's the online benefits. Okay, next, eligible ITC. ITC, input tax credit. A business holder, at the time of purchase, he will pay some percentage of tax. The tax amount will be deducted after the sale of the item. After sale of the item, the amount of tax will be deducted from the purchase tax. That is called input tax credit. Okay, input tax credit available irrespective of payment of tax or filling of valid return by supplier. So in GST, input tax credit available only if supplier pay tax and file valid return. Both are valid returns. Why? Because in case he is missing before the 6 months, up to 6 months, he will take input tax credit. If he cross more than the 6 months, he will not applicable for take a input tax credit. So my dear students, so this is the important key point for who are required, who are wanted to work as a accountant. So the key point is input tax credit will take in within the 6 months of billing date or purchase bill date. Okay, so input tax credit available irrespective of payment of tax or filling of valid return by supplier. Then GST system, input tax credit available only if supplier pays tax and file return. Next, business rating. No rating for the business at the time of VAT system, because of it is applicable only for one state only. That's why they are not given any rates, the state governments, to the business. But GST is applicable entire the nation. GST rating based on timely filling of return and payments. So it is useful for bank loans or any CC account, OD account. CC account means cash credit accounts, OD account, overdraft accounts. So banks given at the time of given bank loans or overdrafts or cash credit accounts, they will check your rating in GST website. So the government or GST rating based on timely filling of return and payments. So if the business holder timely payment of returns and timely all process are completed, the rating will increased by the government. So highest rating persons are taken easily loans from the banks or other sectors. So my dear students, these are the difference between VAT and GST. So I repeat the key points, listen carefully. First one is jurisdiction. So VAT is applicable only one state, more than the one state will not cover. But GST is applicable entire state and out of state, interstate or intrastate transactions. Second one, scope. VAT applicable only on goods, but GST applicable both goods as well as services also. Next, taxable event at the time of VAT, in VAT, sale of goods. Taxable event is sale of goods, but GST taxable event supply of goods. Next, cascading effect. So partially eliminate cascading effect as credit is not available for central sales tax or excise duty, but GST eliminate that, purely eliminate the cascading effect. Tax credit, intrastate transaction get input credit set off, not interstate transactions. So GST interstate as well as intrastate also input tax credit set off. Tax collection, so only state government will collect the tax and GST collect the SGST and CGST also. SGST going amount going to the state government and CGST amount going to the directly by the taxpayer to central government and state government, equal share. Why? Because there is no disputes, that's why the disputes are conflicts. So input credit, VAT liability is calculated by deducting input VAT on goods purchased and from output VAT. So tax, simply say one word about tax, input tax credit. So formula is output tax minus input tax, that is equal to VAT payable amount. Output tax minus input tax is equal to VAT payable amount. GST is applicable on goods as well as services provided. Return filling, GST VAT return filling by 20th of succeeding month. Succeeding month means immediate next month, okay. But GST having three returns: sales return by 10th of succeeding month, purchase return by 15th of succeeding month, and payment 20th of succeeding month. The three returns filed by the business dealer. Next one is registration. Registration at the time of VAT through TIN, tax identification number, GST PAN through PAN registration, permanent account number. Okay, threshold limit 10 lakhs for VAT, 20 lakhs for GST. 20 lakhs is the at the time of 2017. Nowadays, this assessment year will change the threshold limit, that is 40 lakhs. Okay, online payments. So VAT is not compulsory online payment, but GST is more than the 10,000 rupees of tax compulsory online payment. So declaration form like C form, H form, etc. are applicable. So in GST there is no declaration forms. Eligible ITC, input tax credit available irrespective of payment of tax of filing of valid return by the supplier. So ITC also available if supplier pay taxes, file valid return. Supplier pay tax and file valid return. That's why at that time both are satisfied, tax paid and file valid return. Both are satisfied, the party or the second party input tax credit available. And last one, business rating. In VAT system, no rating for the businesses, and GST rating based on timely filling of return and payments. So my dear students, these are the difference between VAT and GST. Okay, thank you so much.